Remember a couple weeks back when I opened up my trunk and there were a couple books back there? Well, today we're gonna figure out why. We're gonna repurpose these books to be a little bit more useful by hiding stuff inside of them. And the classic thing to hide inside of a book is a gun. Pistol's a little large, so we're gonna have to do the pharmacology book. We're gonna tape up this back cover so it doesn't get soaked in water when it's sitting on the table. And now we're folding the covers back. And then we're gonna clamp all the pages between these two pieces of wood. And then we're just gonna cut the design right through here, through the pages, through the bottom. Okay, let's do it. There, Mitchell,
looks like it hit the edge of this support there.
That's why when it got up right here, that was under the edge,
just barely
hit that, and it was going too fast to go through it, so it just started shooting back up here. So whoops. The bottom cover stayed clean though, right? Yeah, better than the top. Okay, pull the core out.
I want to see if I can keep it together.
Got the front, it's just that back piece. There we go. Okay, moment of truth.
Perfect fit. This is just a well-used pharmacology book now. I studied really hard.
Okay, well, we got three more books, so let's figure out what else we can hide in these. Okay, so we've got our pharmacology book. It's hiding our handgun. We picked Tom Clancy to hide a hamburger.
One of the keys to finding a good book to hide things in is a book that nobody's going to want to read. Now, large guns can also be hidden inside books.
Can't even tell. Hey, Mitchell, what you got there?
Oh, just a good book I'm reading, Knife of Dreams.
That looks fantastic.
Yeah, thanks.
See, perfectly.
Just going for some reading.
Perfectly concealed. If you enjoyed watching that video, do the usual, like, share, comment, subscribe. And it's Tuesday, so we actually are announcing a winner for the Batarang giveaway. As soon as we get a response back from the winner, we'll put his name down in the description below, and yeah.
Thanks for watching.
Edward growled back through his teeth. You would have stopped me. You should have been stopped. This isn't about me, I interrupted. I stood very keeping my hold on Renna's me insanity. This is Charlie Jacob. How could you put him in danger this way? You didn't realize it's death or vampire life for him now, too. My voice trembled with the tears of my eyes. Could no longer shed.